All right, guys, I've been browsing the internet. With these bike sales going on, you just keep looking and looking and looking. You never know what you might find. And I saw some things that I think you guys might be interested in. Before I jump into the main one I think you guys would like, I want to talk about a couple bikes that I saw, and I want to know what you guys think about it, because I'm not familiar with these bikes, and I would love to get your guys' feedback to let me know if it's worth checking out or not. Now, the store I'm looking at is in my area. It's called Pedal Pushers. It's in Golden, Colorado. So this might not apply to you guys unless you want to order it online. I don't know if you can or not, but if you live in this area, you can go check it out. And right now I'm looking at this Scott Spark 970. It's down from $28.99 to $23.19. And I'm not too familiar with Scott at all. I know it's really known for its internal rear shock, which is kind of weird, but kind of cool at the same time. But looking at the key features, It's an aluminum frame. It's got the RockShox Judy 130 millimeter fork. It's got the NX SX Eagle 12 speed. It's got Shimano disc brakes and Schraube tires. And it's got a dropper post. So those are the key features that I was looking at. But that RockShox Judy at that price point and at 130 millimeters, I don't really think it's worth it, but I figured it was worth checking out because it's $23.19, and I think that's a decent price for a full suspension bike. I've been hearing a lot of you guys talk about Spark. So what do you guys think about the Spark 970? Is it worth the price that it's knocked down to, or is this something that we should probably just pass on? All right, now on to the next bike. And this is one that caught my eye as well, because I've been hearing you guys mention this bike too. I mean, you mentioned a lot of bikes, but these two were bikes that I've been seeing repeatedly mentioned. And it's the Kona Process 134 29 inch. So this is in my size two, and it's in my price range. So I would love to hear what you guys have to say about this. This bike is medium size. Is down from $28.99 to $2,029. So that's a pretty significant decrease in the price. It's running the RockShox Recon 140 millimeter travel fork. It's got the Shimano Dior crankset, Dior shifters. It's a 1x11 instead of a 1x12, which is not a big deal to me at all. It's got Shimano MT201 hydraulic brakes, which I'm familiar with and I can live with those. It's got a dropper post, Trans-X dropper post, and a derailleur is Shimano Dior as well. So it's actually not bad spec, honestly, for $2,000 for a full suspension bike. You can't really beat that. That's the price of pretty much the Specialized alloy version, the entry-level Specialized stump jumper. I think this would be pretty much the same bike, and I think it'd come down to personal preference which one you decide to get. You do get the 1x12 with the stump jumper, but that's pretty much the difference in my opinion. This is a well-spec bike for the price. I mean, the price that it's marked down to, I definitely wouldn't pay $3,000 for this bike. That's just outrageous in my opinion. But $2,029, that's right there with the Specialized stump jumper, and that's saying something right there. It does have a 1x11, like I said, but that's not a big difference. So let me know what you guys think about the Kona Process 134-29. Is that a good price? Do you think that's a great bike for somebody to upgrade to or just get into full suspension bikes? What category do you think this bike fits? And do you think that's something that I should go check out? I don't know too much about Kona, but I'm willing to try it out. But let me know what you guys think of Kona. Guys, we got some breaking news. I just got an update. I just saw this. I didn't see it last night, but we got to talk about this before I jump into the bike that I really wanted to talk about. This actually might even be even crazier. All right, guys, as I was editing this video, I realized that the sale was over. So I was a day late for the sale on the bikes I'm getting ready to talk about. And I was about to not upload this video, but come to find out, this actually ended up being an interesting thing to talk about, because the two bikes I'm about to talk about is the Trek Roscoe 9 and the Trek Fuel EX7. Both of those were 15% off for about 5 days in my local bike shop. But come to find out, they didn't sell any of them in those 5 days. I ended up going to the bike shop and they were all still there. The top bikes, or a couple of the top bikes, ended up going on sale and nobody pulled the trigger, even on 15%. So I was about to leave this part of the video out of it and just talk about the Scott and the Kona, But when I realized this, I was like, oh, this is actually kind of cool to talk about. So I definitely want to get you guys feedback on this. Once I talk about the prices and everything, do you guys think the 15% off was worth it? Or let me know, was that just not good enough? This is the Trek Fuel EX7 Dior/XT Gen 6 2023 bike. And it's 15% off, down from $36.99 to $31.44. So $3,144. I think this is US prices though, but this is at my local bike shop. So I'm not sure if you can price match wherever you are, if you see one, or how does that work. But if you are in this area or you want to order it online, this bike is available at Wheat Ridge Cyclery. Man, that's tough not to get. I really want that Remedy, but this is really caught my eye. So if it sticks around for a while, I might actually take a look at it. I might end up still going with the Remedy, but this is a great deal in my opinion. Let me know what you guys think. Do you think pretty much $3,100 is worth the Trek Fuel EX7 DRXT, the brand new 2023? It's got a RockShox 35 Gold RL Debonair Spring fork on it. So it's 150 millimeters of travel, 140 millimeters of travel in the rear. So it's ready for everything. It's got the Fox Performance Float Evolve shock on it. So that's pretty awesome. And looking at these specs, mixing the Shimano Dior with the SLX and the XT, it looks pretty similar to what my Roscoe 9 specs are. And it's running Shimano 4-piston hydraulic disc brakes. That's huge. Those brakes are unbelievable. That's one of the things I like most about my Roscoe 9 are the brakes. This is a size medium, so they do have it in my size. Oh my goodness. Yeah, I was not expecting to see this. So if you guys are interested, make sure you go on wheatridgecyclery.com and check it out. It's a size medium. I think that's the only one they have left in a medium. And if you're interested, definitely go out and take a look at it, because if you don't, I might. And it's got the black color too, the matte black. Oh man, see, this is tempting. Yeah, I gotta get off this and talk to you guys about what I originally wanted to talk to you about, because this is gonna make me want to get the Trek Fuel EX7 now. So with all that being said, this is the thing I wanted to show you guys that I couldn't believe I saw last night. Now we go to the brand new 2023 Trek Roscoe 9. They have it on sale 15% off. So $23.79 down from $27.99. Now that's super close to the Roscoe 8. Now that the Roscoe 8 is at $2,000, I do think it's worth stepping up that extra $400 to get the Roscoe 9. So if you can price match wherever you are, or you can order this online, I would definitely try to take advantage if possible. They do have all sizes, so I see anywhere from medium to extra large. I'm a size medium large. I'm about 5'8", so medium large is perfect for me, but they do have medium to extra large, just giving you my size for a little bit of comparison, just in case you were kind of curious. You guys know all about the Roscoe 9. You see my videos all the time. It's spec'd really well, and it's definitely worth the $2,300. I do think it was a little, maybe slightly overpriced at the $27.99, but at $23.79, that's definitely worth it. So if you guys are really looking to get the Roscoe 9, I would try to get it and see if you can either price match or order from Wheat Ridge Cyclery, because it's on sale right now. Not sure how long it'll go on. I'm hoping these sales will keep coming, because they are really starting to pop up now. That's why I'm holding the Trek Remedy 8, but I'm not buying it yet, because I kind of want to keep that on the back burner just in case I find a crazy deal that comes later. Plus it's not park season yet, so I can't really use it for what I want to use it for anyway. So why not wait and see what pops up? But yeah, this is what I wanted to jump on here and show you guys. I hope you guys are excited as I am. Even though I have the Roscoe 9, I'm still excited to see it on sale. But yeah, that Trek Fuel EX7 and the Trek Roscoe 9, great deals. Let me know what you guys think. Do you think they're worth it? And will you guys check those out? If you're in the Denver area, make sure you go check out Wheat Ridge Cyclery, because they got some crazy deals right now. No, it's not sponsored or anything. I just want to keep you guys in the loop and show you guys what I see, because it's a lot of you guys that help me out about stuff I never knew, and I want to help you guys in return when I can. So with all that being said, this is exciting. This is just the beginning too, in my opinion. But if you enjoyed the video, make sure you hit that thumbs up. It really helps, and I really, really appreciate it. Hit that like button. Oh, that's the same thing. hit that subscribe button if you haven't, and I'll see you guys in the next video.